and welcome to this video demonstration showing how the design integration between the Agilent Advanced Design System and the Cadence Allegro PCB design environment can shorten design cycles and improve design quality for RF mixed signal designs. In this video, you will hear Dan Evers of Agilent showing the design flow from an RF design perspective and Gary Hind of Cadence from a PCB design perspective. By seamlessly moving the design between the two environments ensures that the RF design is faithfully incorporated into the PCB and any required modifications can easily be validated in ADS.
So for this demonstration, we're going to take a rather typical RF problem. This is a microstrip coupled line filter with a band pass centered around 11.5 gigahertz. And you'll notice we've got here a schematic composed of parameterized transmission line elements and a corresponding layout constructed from those same parameterized transmission line elements. We've got this in a test bench here, and we've simulated this, and we can see that we really do have the passband where we want it. The goal now is to get this faithfully represented in Cadence as part of a larger mixed signal design. And the crucial thing now is we export both the schematic and the layout with these parameterized information all in one shot. So we can do this from the export menu in the ADS layout. File, export, and this will send both the schematic and the layout complete definitions. Hit the export button. We'll now pass this directory to the engineer completing the larger mixed signal design in which this filter needs to be a part.
We have a mixed signal design that we are going to be using for the destination for the IFF file. As you can see from the design, predominantly digital design. There is some analog circuitry, and I also have a placeholder for an RF block. So as we can see, there's the whole design in its entirety. We'll go back to the project manager. I'll say import IFF, and we'll use RF PCB. And you can see the dialog opens. It asks me for the IFF file, and this is the coupled line filter that you saw earlier. I will import the schematic IFF file, so we'll open this. And then we'll say finish. I'll now launch the schematic tool, and this will be reading the IFF file. So if we go to the sheet that we showed you earlier, and you can see this is where I need to place the design, I'm going to say component and add. And in the library, I've got the filter. If we select the block and descend, and now you can see the schematic circuit of the RF design. Just to show what's actually been transferred here as well, if I select one of the NLIN components and do an attribute, you can see that I've now got the RF parameters, which will give me things like the line length and the width. And actually, on this component, you can see the line length is currently 100 mils. And then I'll just start Allegro PCB. So as you can see, there's a large portion of digital circuitry. There's the analog circuitry that we talked about earlier. We're now ready to go to accept the RF elements. I'll say quick place, and you can see a list of placed components and also some RF elements that need to be placed. I'll select start. Some elements have now been placed along the top of the design. If I window in, here you can see all of the parameterized elements. I'm going to say edit move, select all of these elements, and we'll now actually move over to the area where we'd like to place the component. So now we can see what the RF elements are actually connected onto the this pin of this capacitor in the analog section. Within RF PCB, I can say edit snap, and I can now snap the rest of the circuitry to complete the design. And there we go. This is the coupled line filter that we saw earlier in ADS connected into the mixed signal board. I do have one problem though. There are some mechanical pins that are being placed down here, and I've been told that these cannot be moved. So unfortunately, the coupled line filter actually violates this space, so I need to make some changes. What I'd like to do is change this line to 500 mils. So now you can see it's updated the length of that line, and the circuit now needs to be updated and re-established connectivity. One click, and I've now moved the whole filter, and it's now connected on the change line length. I've made a change to the RF circuit, so I need to be able to provide this back to the RF engineer. I'll select OK, take the default directories, and notice I do have the choice now to export the stack up from Allegro as well. I can even map the Allegro layers to ADS layers. We say OK, export is finished. I now hand that IFF file back over to the RF designer.
And it's important now that we revalidate that circuit to make sure it still conforms to our initial specification. So to bring that layout from Cadence back into ADS, we can simply open a blank ADS layout, and we use File, Import, and we'll choose the IFF option. We can see that the leading transmission line heading into this is considerably longer than it was before. And the question is, does this hurt the response of our filter? We can, from this layout, generate an ADS schematic. We can copy this schematic back into our original test bench. So our initial design will be ports 1 and 2 in the results, and the proposed changes to that design will be ports 3 and 4. We'll rerun the simulation. We'll go back to our data display here. Now, focusing first on the transmitted energy, we can see that we're still essentially the same passband, minor changes, but it's still within our specification. Looking at the insertion loss, we can see some changes here, but again, this fits within our specification, and if not, we could go back and make our adjustments and send the design back to Cadence again.
Thank you for viewing this video about the integrated solution from Agilent and Cadence. There are also three other videos covering other aspects of the design flow, including the transfer of custom copper shapes, synchronizing package parts libraries, and transferring designs with package parts. We encourage you to watch these videos as well to get the complete picture of this integrated solution. And if you haven't experienced ADS firsthand, you can visit this URL to get a free ADS trial license.